In this video, we're going to learn a generalization of the intermediate value theorem. Now for a general topological space. We usually have this theorem for the real numbers with the usual topology. And to prove this theorem, it is essential that we use the supremum axiom. Well, now we're not going to use that axiom, but something very similar, and that is the fact that our domain is going to be a connected space. If you don't remember about connected spaces, then I recommend you check out our previous videos on that topic. If you want to support the channel, you can do so in several ways. You can make donations or become a member on Ko-fi to get access to exclusive content. If in addition to that, you want to get some merchandising, then you can join us on Patreon. That way you can get stickers, mugs, and more. And if you only want the merchandising, then we have a store with all those items available. Let's get into the theorem. Let's see what the theorem is telling us with a small drawing. We have a function, and let's suppose this is our topological space X, and this one our topological space Y. X is connected, and Y is given the order topology for some order that we have defined in the set. And whenever we take two points in our domain, A and B, we look at this image through f of a and b. Here we have f of a and f of b. So what the theorem is telling us is, whenever we graph some element r that is between f of a and f of b, remember that we can do this because y is an ordered set, then there will always exist some point in the domain c such that f of c is equal to this point that we took r. This is a very important theorem. The rest of the video is going to be the proof, so if you're not interested in watching the proof, then just skip to the next one. Let's get on with it. The key idea will be to use both our hypotheses, that X is a connected space and that Y is an ordered set, because given that Y is an ordered set, then I can just consider the intervals minus infinity r open in r, and then the interval r infinity again open in r. And just for a practical case, let's suppose that our function does something like this. We will then consider the intersection of each of these two intervals with the image of our function, with f of x. So in this case, it would be something like this. This set up to here in this open interval, and in this other interval, well, I suppose it goes to infinity in a way. It's not the infinity of the real line, it's the infinity of the set y. So let's suppose we have something like this. Then what we have here is that, let's call these sets a and b. Then we have that, well, f of a is part of a and f of b is part of B. So A and B are non-empty, but they are also disjoint. And so let's suppose that this number C doesn't exist. So there is no C such that F of C is equal to R, meaning that here we will have some hole in our function. So what happens is that we can write F of X as the union of A and B. And because we have these properties for a and b, then a and b form a section of f of x. But remember now that x was connected. And because f is continuous, then f of x is also connected. And so f of x is connected, but I just found a separation. This gives us a contradiction, because we were supposing here that C did not exist. And so C must exist, and we have this. Here you can clearly see the contradiction that F would not be continuous. And like this, we have the intermediate value theorem for any topological space. Now, this proof might seem way easier than the one we have for the real line, but that is because we have so many hypotheses. We have that X is connected, we have that Y is an ordered set, and we have all the properties that we have built up to this point. These are a lot. Look at how long this reproduction list is so far. And this is only the beginning of topology. So yes, this proof is simpler than the one we used in the real lines, but it's also way heavier than the one we used.